Hello everyone, welcome to the channel once again. The name is Guru Boy. Today we do have the iPhone 5 right over here, which is being on the activation lock screen or the hello screen. So right over here, I'm going to show you how to use Silver 6.2 to remove or delete the setup.app from your iPhone 5. So this method works on the iPhone 5C and the iPad 4. So if you do have the A5 device, you need to use the Arduino to put your device into Pan DFU mode. So right here on our MacBook, all we are going to do is to head over to our browser onto this website, which is the Apple Tech 752 website right over here. So I'll put a link in the description of this video for you to click on it. So just head over to the download section and let's download the Sliver 6.2 from the website. So we have to download two files right over from the website. So we will be downloading the Sliver dependency, so which is almost 32 KB, and we will be downloading the latest version of the Sliver for Mac, and which is 6.2, and also this tool is supported for the M1 chips. So if you do have M1, you need to download the M1 release version. So make sure to download the M1 version. So I'll be downloading the regular one right over here. So I do already have been downloaded. So all we have to do is to just close our browser and head into the download folder. So here we do have the download folder. So let's open the Silver 6.2 DMG file. So let's open it and then wait for it to verify the DMG file. So let's wait, and as soon as it finish verifying, it will open and we have to drag the Sliver into the application folder. So all you have to do is to drag the Sliver into the application folder. So if you do already have the Sliver being downloaded, there's no need to do that. So since I do have it on my desktop or on my Mac, there's no need for me to do it again. So all you have to do is to move to the download or the applications folder or the applications. So right over here in our application, we do have, let's scroll to, we see we do have verify that we do have the Sliver being installed into our application. So the next step is to open our application and then launch terminal. So now the moment you launch the terminal, let's type in this command, which is the XATTR space, then drag in the Sliver, then hit on enter. So if you are if you are being prompted to input your password, make sure you input the password of your Mac and then continue. So here we do have Sliver being installed on our application. So let's open it, and here we do have Sliver working on our Mac device. So all we have to do, and here are the functions of the Sliver. So all we have to do is to put Sliver aside and head into our terminal once again and type in sh space, then you drag in your dependency file. So let's move to the download section and drag in our dependency file. So drag in your dependency file and hit on enter. So if it requires you to provide your password, your MacBook password, make sure to enter your Mac password. So here it just prompts me to input my password, so I don't need to install the dependency file once again. So I do already have the dependency file installed. And if this is your first time running Sliver, make sure to run the dependency file in the terminal. So now let's move to the next step, which is restoring our device and putting it into the Pan DFU before it boot up. Okay, so now let's restore our device using the iFault tool, which is the alternative 3 tool for Windows, or you can use the iTunes to restore your device, depending on the tool you use to restore your device. So let's move to wait for the iPhone tool to launch and just connect our device to the iPhone tool and then begin to restore our device. So I'll put a link for this tool also in the description of the video, so make sure to check the description for the link of this tool. Now let's connect our phone to the Mac and wait for it to be detected by the tool. And here we do have our phone being detected in the tool. So all you have to do is to close the pop-up menu, then click on the smart flash. So when you click on the smart flash, you will be able to see the available iOS version for your device. So here you can download the IPSW file which is available for your device by clicking on the download and wait for the download to be done. Since I do have it, I'll pause the download and then delete the download since I don't need the download. So now the next step is also to import if you do have the download file or the IPSW file already being downloaded from the internet. You can import it by clicking on the import. So now let's choose our iOS version, in which I'm going by the 10.3.4. So now click on flash. So if you're having hard time with this tool, you can just use the 3U tool or the iTunes. So let's click on the flash and click OK, and then wait for our device to be flashed or restored. So I'll speed up the process. So you should know this, we are not going to allow the device to boot up after flashing the device or restoring the device. So all we are going to do is to hold the power and the home key to put the device into recovery mode. So now we are, now let's press the home and the power key, count 1, 2, 3 and release the power key. Now keep holding the home key till you see your device in DFE or DFE mode. So now we have our device in DFE mode showing in the tool right over here. So let's click on the device info, and now we do see our device is in DFE mode. So make sure you do not let your device boot up after restoring your device. So now let's head over to the Apple Tech 752 software, click on the Ramdisk iCloud bypass, then move into the Asus device. So since our device is Asus, click on Asus and then choose your device type. Mine is iPhone 5. Click on enter pan DFU. So click and wait for the device to be in pan. Yeah, successful. For the first time trying, we are not successfully exploit worked successfully for the first time. So our device is in pan DFU mode now. So click on OK, and now let's load Ramdisk. So if you do have Mojave, Catalina, Big Sur, or Monterey, you have to use the alternative Ramdisk to load your device. So after loading or click on load, disconnect your USB cable from your phone for 5 seconds and then plug in your USB cable. So let's plug in the USB cable and click on continue. So let's click on continue. And now you should see VirtualBox boot on your device. Then after the VirtualBox boot, you should see an Apple logo with Apple Tech 752 text on the screen. So here we do have it. And if you do not see this logo on your device, meaning the Ramdisk did not work successfully, so you have to reboot your device and make sure the device do not turn on, and then put it back into the DFU. Now relay device info, click on yes to start SSH. Now TCP activated. So now the next step or the last step we are going to do is to delay the setup.app. So click on setup.app, and the moment you click on it, your device should reboot, and then click on OK and wait for a device to reboot. So for the first time your device is being booted, it will take at least 5 to 10 minutes to boot up your device since it's been erasing, and after erasing your device will boot up. So you do have this message showing our device has been on the activation lock screen. So the next video that I'm going to show you is to how to copy music from iTunes straight to your device or syncing your phone to your iTunes. So make sure to subscribe to the channel and stay tuned for the next video. So if you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe and turn on the notification bell when I do upload that video. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe to the channel. The name is Guru Boy. Thanks for watching. Peace.